Hi, my name is James Mackie and I am the mad scientist. I'm here in Tokyo and I'm going to do a follow-up of my first HoloLens video, which actually received 1 million views. And this time I'm going to dive even deeper into the more advanced augmented and mixed reality applications. I just want you to know that everything you're about to see is a real life representation of what I'm seeing because it's recorded directly from the HoloLens.
On the way over, I geometrically mapped the plane so I could pin things to different parts of the plane and also watch holograms in the spaces. As you can see, it's surprisingly accurate and I can map just about every single piece of furniture, ceiling, wall or floor. If I save this mapping, I can then view this space later on. What would you rather watch, this or this? I can interact with a hologram and it knows whereabouts I am and it knows where it is too on the plane.
You can access this module from conventional.
Not quite sure what people think with this thing on your head, so hoping for it to get smaller soon. So now I'm in my hotel room. Would you rather watch this TV or this one?
Or this?
And in the gym. Now, I know this looks really shaky, but that's because it's on my head and obviously I'm working out, so my head's shaking around. But to me, it's perfectly aligned. I can shake my head and my body as much as I want and everything stays in the same place. The holograms always look very crisp and stationary.
Okay, Arnie, if you're listening, I've got an idea. 360 video and 3D video already exists on HoloLens. What if, when I was in this gym, or any gym, it was geometrically mapped, and then all of a sudden, I'm in Gold's Gym, Venice Beach, aka your gym, you're working out next to me on one of the benches, Louis Ferrigno's working out on another bench, shouting to me, James, just one more rep, one more rep. That would be such an awesome AR immersive experience, and give me 5% of that please if you do follow that one up. Okay, on to the next.
This game is called Robo Raid, and as the name suggests, it's robots raiding my house or my hotel room. When I click to fire into the wall, a hole is created, and you can see right into the back of the wall, you see these wooden beams, so when I move my head, they realistically move, so it does definitely feel like there are holes in the wall. I've also got a duck, the robots invading my hotel room, move out the way of the lasers.
They're going behind the walls.
And this just really is spatial computing at its best. Okay, so this is called Fragments. Get ready for this one.
Great. Looks like we are in sync. I don't know what you'll see, investigator, but your first case has begun.
Now just look here how my boring hotel carpet has been changed into wooden floorboards that are being rained on in a murder scene.
Help! Mom! Dad! Somebody! Please! Help me!
I told you to shut the hell up!
So that was Fragments on the HoloLens, which was an incredible mixed reality experience to be part of, where I had these 3D volumetric characters to interact with. But what I can't help thinking is the real life implications of this headset. What about people who are partially sighted and AR could be used to fill in the blanks? Or what about people with Alzheimer's who need a memory recoiled when a family member's about to visit, and just before the family member visits, the hologram or the memory is put into their field of view? The potential real life scenarios and implications of AR are very, very, very important and exciting.
I move as close as I can to these characters and you can see all of the pigments of the skin and even the fine lines on their faces. I've used VR and this is just as good, if not better. I just wanted to show you a 360 video. So this is a hologram and everything else is my hotel room. And now I'm going to go into southern Peru on the Inca Trail. So my first reaction to this, I actually swore And you can see it's pretty immersive and good quality because you can see the people. They're all small, but you can see them fairly accurately. And you can look anywhere around because it's a fully immersive 360 video.
A small band of Spanish conquistadors leading 30,000...
And now we are back in the room.
Okay, how far is it from there to there? Oh, 5.291 meters.
Now I am in Okinawa Aquarium. I wonder what these whale sharks would make of it if they could see what I can. And do these whale sharks really need to be here if we can live stream their holographic selves? Just to give you an idea of scale, I could continually enlarge this shark without limitation. As you can see, the shark is larger than the whale sharks in the aquarium and as large as the hall, which is 35 meters long. Is this the largest hologram ever created?
No one is an AR expert. We think we know about the possibilities of what AR can achieve, but we have absolutely no idea. Just like in the early 2000s, when the smartphone was invented, we thought that mobile email was this amazing technological advancement. But now look back at the millions of mobile apps that have been created for every possible idea you could conceive, and every idea that you possibly couldn't conceive looking back at the last 10 or 15 years. So now we're at that same point with AR. But the difference with AR is that our reality is based on what we see. Our brain then translates that information into our temporal perceived reality. And now with AR, we can add anything into that mix. So surely it's not just the end of the PC display, but it's the end of the smartphone, the end of forgetting stuff, the end of branding or branded advertising. I mean, why have a tin of baked beans in a shop with a label printed, when you could literally holographically project the label onto the tin of baked beans, centrally update the price, the branding, the colours, and without having to print those labels? So no one really knows what the future holds for AR, and my only concern is around privacy, the camera constantly recording at a much higher resolution than, let's say, CCTV. But I think that the benefits far outweigh the pitfalls of AR. And in my next video, I'm going to go into a rant about Unity and how and why I think you should start thinking of ideas about 3D holographic apps to create, because it's going to be the next huge technology mega trend, and the tools are already there to start building these applications, and it's going to create a lot of success and wealth in the tech industry and potentially anyone who can come up with these ideas now and for the next 10 or 15 years. So please watch that video when I release it in a couple of weeks. And also please subscribe to my channel. There's a subscribe button in the bottom right. And thank you very much for listening.